There are big differences between China and US. The most obvious one, of course, is a very different system of the government. And while China's economy has grown to be the second largest in the world, it still suffers from the growing pains experienced by all the developing economies. The regulations that Chinese government focused on can be categorized into four basic areas: financial protection, data security, antitrust, protection focused on society. Despite the big differences between the US and China, investors may actually recognize many of the same issues addressed by Chinese regulators as issues we've been grappling with for more than a decade. For better or for worse, the one-party system in China allows for quick, if imperfect, ways to address these issues. China is concerned about the increasing power invested in certain massive internet companies. Recent regulation which halted the IPO of Ant Financial last year due to its extremely high leverage ratio, as well as the requirements to review data security plans and the prohibition of blocking links to rival firms, or touch on the regulators' goals of financial protection, increasing competition, and data security. Also happening here in the US, there have been countless data breaches of consumers' personal information. And we see how many times have Mark Zuckerberg been grilled in front of the Congress and to Google, Twitter. Even the president outlined this past spring increased the scrutiny of the proposed merger and acquisition activity in the US tech sector, concerned about the size and the power of these companies. In terms of the crackdown on education industry, China's extremely competitive education system has drained the low and middle class finance, as many families have made a priority of tutoring children in very expensive after-school programs. While it's not apple to apples, the US continues to search for ways to make education more affordable to our youngs. Most recently, this has included the controversial proposal to eliminate the student debt. US and China share many of the same societal issues and interests when it comes to big data and big internet monopolies. Of course, China's way of dealing with them are sharply different. The short-term headline risk is caused by what Americans see as abrupt or even arbitrary ruling by Chinese regulators. In the US, we tend to see the regulation coming a mile away. Even then, the regulation can be challenged and often end up in the courts. The Chinese authority themselves admitted that the announcement of some of their regulatory efforts could have been handled more delicately. And we believe their hunger for the foreign capital investments will lead to a more open and transparent regulatory regime over time. If your wealth management's view of China's long-term investment prospects look far beyond the narratives behind most media reporting of China's recent regulated move, this narrative ignores the strong parallels between the issues is facing the Chinese from its large and growing digital economy and those facing the US citizens. It even ignores the parallels between some of the Chinese regulations and those sought by a large percentage of the US citizens and politicians. No doubt, much of this narrative stemmed from the strategic rivalry between the two countries. But CCR continues to point to the long-term trajectory of the Chinese middle class and the increasing importance of the Chinese consumer. We're also highly skeptical of the central premise of this narrative, which never spilled up, but lurked below the surface. that is somehow Chinese authorities are seeking to hobble the private firms which voted them to their current place on the world stage. It's clear to see from the two charts here, the private firm are actually the engine of the China's growth and job creation. Almost 90% of urban employment is in the private companies. And private firms also account for the majority of the China's exports. So we don't believe China's aim is to kill the goose that lays golden egg. Of course, CCR Wealth Management will continuously assess the risks to our clients' portfolios. Should facts and events dictate, we stand ready to reassess our outlook and take the swift actions. But for now, we view the news about China's regulated moves as the definition of headline risks. And we believe investors would do well to place more weight on the region's long-term prospects in their assessment of China.